Hello and welcome to From the Depths. My name is Karma, and of course I'm joined by Robot A and Robot B. And we're on the small little dingy little craft in the vehicle designer. Because today I wanted to try and do something I thought would be a really nice idea to try out, since we now have the new advanced cannons in. We can now get a lot more customization of our guns. See, what I want to do is, build a rather famous anti-aircraft gun right here in front of the depths. The 88mm Flak gun from good old World War II. I seem to be completely dead and out of brains today. Anyways, let's get started, shall we? Now, go to build here. First thing we need to do is actually make the shell that we're going to be using. Because, after all, a gun is consisting of a barrel, firing pin, and a chamber for ammunition, but the biggest factor of a gun is, of course, the ammunition that's put in it. That's what makes the ammunition. Now, the ammo controller. Just thinking, we might not have enough room in this ship. It might be a little too small. So we'll do it anyway. Shell parts. We'll line it up here. Output feeder. Put it there. And, of course, shell parts. I'm going to only put a few pieces at first. I think because while we're. This is connected to things. Alright, now, let us begin. Right. Now, Elliot Flak Millimeter fired a. It fired an 88mm caliber shell that was. I have the page open here, so because I'm not going to remember all these values out of my head, you know. Now, of course, they don't tell us exactly what kind of of shell composition, but we do know some things like the actual shell length and what it was used for. So let's start at first beginning. We're going to go shell nose. Now first I'm just going to try and figure out the actual bullet size, because we're going to ignore the casing for a moment. We're going to go, I think the best would be, what's this? I haven't seen this. Armored piercing capped head. Shell size head, which provides an increase in AP with low chance of shell fragmenting in post armor. Maybe capped head. Composite head. Oh, I think it was scope. Composite head. Now we start with shell body. We're going to go Flak warhead, I think. It's an explosion that is larger in radius but less damaging than standard HE1. I believe that's what we want. Flak warheads, Flak warheads, Flak warheads. Now, the shell diameter is. If we go here, we can get. Oh, come on. 89. We got 88. 8. 88. That's our shell we want. Optional barrel length. Length of shell. Shell length, ignoring casing, is 352. Now, the actual shell was 571mm. This is 352mm. So if we put another one of these, we'll go up to 44, which means we're going to need a lot more of these ammo customizers, so we can lengthen the shell. That should be enough, I think. It's going to be a ridiculously long shell. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's make it 8. Length of shell rack needed is 2 meters. Ooh, sadly, that's going to be strange. Though I just want to see if we're going to go 2 meter shell rack. We're going to push this until at 2 meter shell rack is completely full. Length of shell rack needed 2 meters. Okay, so we're going to really push it. Can we still fit this in a 2 meter shell rack? Yeah, we can still fit this into a 2 meter shell rack. Right. Of course we're not going to actually be firing this, because that'll be completely ridiculous. And we're going to add gunpowder casings until our shell length below there becomes the desired length we want. Which is, if we look here, it is, what was it again? 5, 7, 1. 7, 9, 2, 7, 4, 6, 1, 6, 5, 2, 8, 5, 7, 4. Looks like we can't really get 5, 7, 4. But we have got a lot of interesting here. Now if we go to... Oh. So now we're going to, of course, what we need for a flak warhead is a timed fuse. Now the reason why I'm going to go timed fuse and not say altitude or proximity fuse is because that's pretty much how these things used to work, is that you had a little thing on the ground and you turned it, twisted it, it would tick a fuse, and the moment it fired, that fuse would start ticking, 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 and explode. Bang. That's what it's like. Now you think, oh, if I now put a time... I put in 2 time fuses. Wait, is that flak wide? Right, flak. This is how I put time fuses. Now, you might think, time fuse, it's just going to... What if it happens if the target's beyond the range, within the range? It's going to be useless. But, my friend, there is a device in the custom cannons that allows you to adjust the timed fuse on the fly, depending on where the target is. Brilliant piece, you know. So now we have a timed fuse right at the end. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4 flak warheads and a composite head. And our shell length is 528, as we require. Am I derping here? Could it be that this is the thing where it says shell length is 571 with casing? No. No, I would have said this is the actual shell we're talking about. But yeah, enough derping, I think. We have our shell, and now here's another problem I think we're gonna run into. Let's go, expected muzzle velocity is 467 if we have an optimal barrel length. That's a problem. Look here, just this one. Expected muzzle velocity. The actual velocity of the 88 was 820 meters per second. We're at half this required speed. A bit irritating. Also, the optimal barrel length propellant burn is 9. Cut that out. Optimal barrel length propellant for propellant burn is 20 meters of barrel. We don't have 20 meters of barrel. The actual flak gun was an L56, and by L56 it was 56 times the caliber. 88 times 56 was 4,926 millimeters, which is 5 meters. We're not going to be very successful with this, I believe. Though, we have a lot of gunpowder casings. We might be able to get close, hopefully. We could maybe increase the amount of these we have in here, but that is going to get really ridiculous. I won't. But now, let us move on to the turret. This little bugger over here is going to be very happy when we place this. So let's begin. We're going to go for a metal block place. Downslope, 4 meters, 4 meters, 4 meters, 4 meters. Now we place here custom cannon. New object, spin turn block. Now, two axis turret, because we're not going to go one axis turret, because you'll see in a moment why I'm doing this. Oh, he's already taking control of it. Little bugger. We're still working on it. Now, advanced cannons. Now, if you take a look at a Flak cannon, you notice it's... Well, I'll post a picture for you up now so you can look at one. It's got a specific style. I'm going to try and recreate that. Metal block. Metal... That's the difficult part. Deciding on what pieces you have, how to make what you're going to make. Put this here. I think we should put metal block. Then put downslope here. Then we're going to do metal triangle corner. 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 Listening to the side so much. What's that guy doing in the control place? I'm rather worried. I might have built a very shitty ship to build this thing on. Right, triangle corner. It would help if I put the mirror line. Go for a 2 meter slope. Corner piece, triangle. Oh. Let me just close these doors. I think water's leaking in. Right, doors closed. Now we go. Advanced cannons. I think we'll start with the autoloader. We need a 2 meter. Put that there. Then we'll put behind it. Gauge increase. There we go. Gauge increase. One gauge increase. And I say gauge increase because if we go here, this cannon. Reduce this all the way down as in centimeters, so 8.8. It's 8.8 centimeters. I think we can move this up a bit. Can we try and move this up a bit? Yes, we moved this up a bit. Now we go. Gauge increase. And then go. Let's fire a piece. And go desired gauge of shell 8.8. Alright. Yeah. Brilliant. Now we go Mantlet? No, we're not going to go for a mantlet. Because, specifically, I don't want to use a mantlet for this thing to get the right style. Because it's going to... If I can demonstrate here quickly, it's going to have to look up and aim like that. Now... Now, at the front here, we're going to put here barrels. Where's the barrels? I've completely lost my location. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is the barrel length we had there. Shell barrels is 0.088. Yes. Right. Correct. If we go here. Now, of course, we're going to have to put an ammo clip here because of fire rate reasons. I know the real idiot didn't have an ammo clip, but we can sort of hide it here and no one will notice it. I think they probably would. You know it's there. I know it's there. Can't lie. And of course, we can now use this ammo control, the ammo router, to get the ammo here. We can use that as a looking like a breech, which is nice. Controller, up and select. There's one long ass shell. It's loaded. Do you want before the next one loads? Let's give a test fire of this shell, basically as it is. Seem to have shifted quite a lot. Yeah, it's got barely any speed. Though it's coming very far. I probably shouldn't have taken the time for 15. So, it's sort of working. Controlling here was number one. Are you number one? Can't be. I'm confused. Sorry if you came here for detailed, intelligent designs, because you're not going to get it. Now, hydraulic recoil absorbers, because Flak 88 had recoil reducers. Sort of in that position, I believe. Yeah. Yeah. There it is. Fast and easy. But still. It doesn't have the same speed. Nowhere near the same speed. If I now want to actually go here and edit this thing a bit, so we can get the speed right. One, two, three, four, five. Get one of those barrels on. Yeah, it's going at mass 200. Though, in from the depth terms, that's freaking fast. That gets us up to orbit. I guess maybe for a scaled down, this would be fine. Well, as a model. Though, now comes the more important thing. If we want to actually make this viable for like campaign battles and whatnot, we need to get a few things. It's not really going to fit with the look of it, but hey. Follow shot and laser targeter. That way. Got a little predictor for us, and shell is ready. I just want to check you something. Flak damage. 146. Expected flak range is 12 meters. Wonderful. Oh, I'm going to want to go save vehicle here, and now I'm going to spawn deep water plane, something very easy to shoot down. It's probably going to go very bad, very fast. It's taking them out. Damage it. It's not doing a lot. Right, there goes some more off. Even if this is, it's going to detonate. That's one little thing about the laser targeter. Too damaged. Wonderful. You're going to capsize us, idiot. There you go. It's flak design. I'm not really pleased with this. It's the limit of what I could do. Maybe if there was more support for getting things down on there. But I could also, one thing I can change, I'm still here, is the fire rate. Currently our cooldown is 6 seconds. And reload from shell rack is reload time from clip is 5. So we can actually bring that to 5. While firing before the cooldown period is finished, firing before properly cooldown gives an accuracy decrease and recoil increase. So if we increase this to, I believe we increase this by 1, we're firing 1 second earlier. I believe so. No, we're firing 1 second earlier. Meaning we'll be closer to our actual fire rate. Because the actual fire rate on the Flak 88 was, it's around here somewhere. Rate of fire, 20 rounds per minute. Which gives you about 3 seconds between shots, which is, and if you come with me, this is not 3 seconds. 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004, 1005. No, that's not 3 seconds. Probably to do that, would you have to add another clip, but then that would sort of ruin the view of it. Right now we've got the clip nicely hidden and we can still get off a decent fire rate with the thing. So I hope you enjoyed this actually. It's sort of interesting to do this. Maybe you want to suggest a different kind of gun I could make. Now, I've got to put this on the forums so people who are interested can actually play around with this. Thank you very much for watching. Stay safe. Happy sailings, I should say. I should find out what the Germans of World War II would say. Because it'll fit in with the theme. First off, rambling. That's goodbye from me, and goodbye from Dude A, Dude B. What should we call it?